attention should be on the fighter, dog. You know what I mean?
Best. Who's the best fighter in the UFC right now? You said Henry Cejudo.
Henry Cejudo.
What about John Jones? What about Conor? Nate Diaz?
Nate Diaz, yeah, of course. Both of them. Nick Diaz, to me, is the best of all time. Diaz. I like Nate Diaz, too. Nate is right there, too. But Nick Diaz, man, they fucked his career. Oh, they just politically got his fucking career. Nick Diaz is a whole nother issue, man. That motherfucker should be a multi-hundred-dollar, hundred-billionaire because Nick was a bad motherfucker. Nate, too. They fucked with Nate so much. Nate came, they thought they had a live one when Conor fought Nate. Nate came and beat his ass and shit. Second fight, Nate was hurt. Nate still almost won. I still almost won that shit, too.
I told you. He dropped him in the last round.
Yeah, but right now, I think Cejudo right now is probably the best. And John Jones. But John Jones, shit always happens weird with that guy. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
The Diaz brothers, we jump up into our neighborhood.
Yeah, the Diaz brothers. Yeah, yeah.
That's how much we love them.
We love the Diaz brothers.
You have a world champ, Denise Estrada.
Hello, world champ.
How come women's MMA is more popular? Am I right?
Yeah.
It has more buzz, more. Why is that?
Ask her that.
I feel like, it just started when Dana White took a chance with it, so I think that's why now women's boxing is coming back, because now there's more promoters. They see that, and it's like, you know, monkey see, monkey do. Like, they see how UFC made it happen with Ronda Rousey, and now they got to keep up with the times. Like, times are changing. Now it's like, you know, women's rights stuff, this and that. It's like huge right now, so, and every sport's changing, even like in golf and tennis, like, women are...
Well, you know what, Cindy? Wait, let me forget. I'm gonna be a male chauvinist pig. Like,
We're gonna get hate groups. Hate groups.
I'm gonna tell you why
women MMA.
Why women MMA is getting more popular? And if you look at the crowd, the guys in the crowd, they're looking at the positions that the women get into.
The horny perverts.
Honestly, guys, they follow the horny perverts. They're like, ooh, check, and they say, but they don't do that with the dudes. Maybe the girls do, but so if you look on TV where the camera, boom, fires in on.
Right on
so
the it's cooter.
Becoming, it's becoming more of a show.
Sex sales type shit?
You know, sales? Look at boxing, they wear trunks. Conservative
yeah,
trunks.
Yeah, you're right. I never thought of that.
They wear conservative trunks. The one girl that got real popular was Mia St. John.
Yep, and she
was to wear pink and a...
And she was in Playboy, don't you?
And she would wear tight shorts, you know what I mean? So
and was popular at that time, though,
she
too,
became
right,
very,
right.
very popular. Okay, so the way the mind thinks, forgive me, this isn't me, but the way the men's mind thinks, it's like, we don't really care who wins.
Do you agree?
I agree with that, yeah. I mean, sex sells, but... I think in MMA, the fans are so different. Like, if you lose a fight, MMA fans are still supporting you. In boxing, like, fans are just assholes.
You're right.
If you lose a fight,
damn,
it's like...
why is that?
Joshua loses.
Like,
he's a gold medalist.
I never thought of that.
He's a bum.
Exactly. All of a sudden,
why
he's a bum. Sucks.
I like both. I watch you. Look, I do a lot of shows all the time. I make it a point to try to schedule my shows around UFC and boxing matches all the time. I got a couple of homies. There's only a couple of homies that really get down with me that really know... the fight game, like on my level. Glasses Malone is one of them. Glasses Malone.
Where's he at?
Yeah. Man, I should have called him, man.
Shout out to Glasses Malone.
Shout out to my boy Glasses Malone. He's one of the only artists out there that really know
his
shit. He knows his boxing too, yeah, yeah.
You know, you gotta remember, men suck, okay? I mean, there was a beautiful picture of this soccer player, a female. Beautiful, right? And she was kicking. Bam! She was kicking and her leg was this high. She was kicking and her shorts were up and there was such controversy. All the men were controversy about, wow, I'd let her kick me in the face. But because of the fact of her shorts. And I thought, you know, I think of it, you know, because I got a daughter. So it's like, you know, that sucks, you know.
And boxing, there's been fighters.
The picture was beautiful.
Female fighters who can't fight, but they try to style their bodies and stuff.
They're being marketed.
My dad and my brothers won't let me do anything like that.
No, but you don't need to. I mean, you're a case of a good face. A good face. You got a beautiful face and a good face for boxing. The way you fight, like you don't. The way you fight is like it's almost like Roy Jones. I guess you do like Roy Jones. You say Roy,
yeah.
Because You like draw them in, and you know, you're not just a basic one too.
Roy Jones did this in a fight, and I'll never forget it. Like this, because roosters do that, and I seen her do it.
You know what he told me, Danny? Is when he said he told me, and I have an interview with him where he tells me he took moves from his roosters.
Roosters, yeah, his animals. I know that.
Wow, he watches animals fight.
I'm down. Oh my God.
I find that video boxing. You were there when I interviewed him.
Yeah, yeah.
I introduced you to him that day.
He would try to catch them because of timing. They're so fast. So
he's big into roosters.
He learned that from Rocky. I remember Rocky was chasing the motherfucker.
You know, a lot of people in boxing don't like the Rocky movies.
What?
A lot of Robert Garcia's never watched it.
What?
And a lot of, they feel like it's not realistic enough. They want it. It's a great story.
But you know what? It's a movie. It's a
movie. You know why? Because it's actually a love story. It's not a boxing movie. Yeah. It's actually a love story. So you gotta actually enjoy movies in order to.
You know what?
I
gotta tell you something. Like my son said something really cool because I just thought about it's a bad movie, and he goes. My son goes, yeah, that movie probably supported 120 people and bought 130 bikes for Christmas and maybe made a car payment in the house. And what are you talking about? His dad, how could it be a bad movie? Look at all the people it supported. So to me, there's no such thing as a bad movie. Rocky might not have been my choice for the Oscars, but it was a lot of fun to watch.
Hey.
And it did inspire a lot of people to get into
Rocky
boxing.
Is one of the best ones. Rocky 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah, get on.
And 4. Well, 4 was when he went to Russia, right?
Yes.
3 is my favorite.
5
and 1.
Pushing it.
But it's a story about underdogs. It's not even a story about. You're right. The fight scenes could have been better. Back in them days when they were punching shit, it was so fake and shit. Nowadays it's more better. But my favorite boxing movie of all time was probably Raging Bull. Jake LaMotta. Now that was a true story.
That was awesome.
With Robert De Niro?
And it won Oscars. Yeah, he played Jake LaMotta.
Yeah.
They do a lot of boxing movies in Hollywood. Baseball, basketball, and boxing.
They should do a Bobby Chacon movie, I'm telling you.
Play by Danny Trejo?
And call it Chacon. And just call it Chacon.
I used to spar with Bobby Chacon when he was a kid.
Really?
When I come out of the joint, it was in 1970. And he was just a kid, him and hi, baby!
Hey, stranger.
Her last two fights, she stopped the girl in the sixth round and stopped the girl in the fourth round. They couldn't get off the stool. Beat them down. Just like
they didn't even come out to fight anymore.
Body shots. They said, I don't want them more.
What made you start fighting?
Good job. Boxing. My dad, I would watch boxing with him when I was like 5, 6 years old.
Really?
I started when I was 8. So he was a big Roberto Duran fan. So
he was?
Would
okay.
Sit me down to watch boxing fights with him. Old tapes he would put in.
Yeah. Just like, I still watch old fights.
Me too. That's all I watch. Listen. Yeah, so I started... I asked him if I can box, and he said no. He said it's for boys. My brother's played baseball from T-ball all the way to high school. So I asked if I can play baseball. He's like, no, that's for boys too.
Damn.
He's like, you can cheerlead. I'm like, I don't want to cheerlead. I want to play baseball or I want to box. So I begged him for like 6 months. Every day he would lie to me. He was like, I'll take you tomorrow. So finally, he took me to a gym in Alhambra. And the trainer was like, well, we don't train girls, and plus she's too small, so bring her back when she's like 13. So I got in the car and started crying. My dad was like, oh, shoot, I guess I gotta take her to a gym. So he took me to where his friend Paul Gonzalez, they grew up in the
Paul
projects
Gonzalez
together.
From old school Paul Gonzalez? From the Olympics?
Yeah, from the Olympics. They grew up together.
I know Paul Gonzalez.
Yeah. Frankie Gomez grew up with her too.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Frank,
man.
He was a monster.
Frankie's savage.
Yeah.
What happened to him? What's he doing?
He just...
He quit? I thought he was going to be a champion for sure.
Lost the passion for
Paul
it.
Paul Gonzalez was before De La Hoya, right?
He was before 1984, right?
88
Olympics,
88.
Yeah.
He was 88?
Yeah.
So. What was De La Hoya?
92.
Because I remember watching Paul Gonzalez. I remember. Oh, no, but that's who she grew up with. That's who she was with. Paul
Gonzalez.
Yeah.
My parents grew up with Paul. My dad were friends growing up as kids. And my dad would train with him at home back youth center in East LA. And like, of course, Paul was getting ready for the Olympics, and he was like taking it seriously. My dad was like in gangs using drugs, so like he didn't take boxing very serious. So he took me to home at the youth center when I was 8, and he's like, Paul is my daughter, she wants to box. I was like, all right, well, I'll give her a chance. So started there, kept going. And like 2 weeks into training, he put me in the ring to spar with a boy because he wanted me to get beat up. He's like, Paul, put her in the ring with this boy so she can start crying.
Oh, your dad called that?
Yeah.
Ooh.
So she can cry and like not want to come back to the gym.
Ooh.
So I got in there and I like,
beat the shit out of him. Yeah.
You made him cry?
He hit me with a body shot that like took my whole soul out of me. And I couldn't couldn't breathe. So my dad was like, all right, I think she's done. Right when he said that, I rushed him. I literally ran at him. Like, started swinging, like my arms were flying from like down here. Beat him up, and he started crying, and he never went back to the gym.
Dang.
So, since then, my dad
started
training me.
Sorry, guy.
You changed his whole life.
Yeah, he could have been a champion of the world one day. Now you fucked it up. Now you're
actually,
fucking
I don't know.
He's a doctor.
Now he's looking back there and fucking.
That's awesome.
I get like these random messages on like Instagram from like guys who I grew up with in the gym. They're like, damn, I remember when you kicked my ass when we were like 10. Like, so funny.
She beat up JoJo Diaz when you were little.
We used to squall.
Really?
Yeah.
JoJo's good.
He was good, yeah.
JoJo's good.
He used to go at it.
Really?
I used to throw it Frank.
You guys the same age?
How's JoJo? Yeah, he's might be a year older than me.
At least
me.
A year older.
He just called out three people. Tevin Farmer, Abner Mars, and who's the third one?
Tank.
Devante.
Yeah. Girl power. Yeah.
He's
I like JoJo. He's a nice guy. Always been super sweet. He's a good fighter, so.
Who are you calling out? You calling out anybody?
No.
You're in Texas? Texas?
Oh, Esparza? Yeah, she doesn't like me, but
I thought you guys were going to fight, no?
I'm sure we are.
Are you the same weight?
Yeah.
Yeah, with the same weight. Okay. But I mean, of course.
Same promoter, right?
Same promoter. It's got to be built up. I mean, I got to get a title, I'm sure. She does too, so maybe.
Who's the champ in your thing?
There's somebody from Mexico who's a WBC champion, and then there's somebody from like Argentina, so they're all.
Have you ever fought any girls from like Asia?
I fought somebody from the Philippines.
The girl she knocked out was from the Philippines.
Oh, she was? Okay.
There's a champion in Japan though. I'd like to fight her. Really? I just want to fight any of the world champions if I want to get all the belts. So.
Let's go, line it up. Who
are there too many belts in boxing? Every division has like 4 or 5 belts. Every
Man,
division.
It should be WBC, WBA, and IBF.
What about WBO?
WBO came kind of late too, right? WBO came
but then IBO too?
IBO? What the fuck is IBO?
Lennox Lewis had that title forever.
Andy Ruiz is one of his belts.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm down with
yeah,
it then.
That's the green one, you're right. Daniel knows his stuff.
Okay, that's
so you have 5 sanctioning bodies. And now with a lot of...
You know what I found out about that shit?
What?
I don't want to burst almost bubble. But little did I know until I found out that... If you're gonna fight for the WBA title, WBC, whatever the sanctioning bodies, you gotta pay them like $200,000, dog. Like
3%.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck?
3%.
I've never heard word. So that's like someone winning the Super Bowl, then we gotta pay you for the Super Bowl trophy, right?
3%.
Does that happen? Is that true?
That's why Cotto gave up the belt when he fought Canelo.
I think all champions are gonna start saying, man, fuck these belts.
Wilder told me when he goes to fight all the belts, he's gonna give them up because he said it.
That's all. But yeah, that's 12%.
Isn't that what like? Mayweather did a lot? Or